I am going to talk about the glucose patterns that you will be seeing in your clinical practice in patients with diabetes. What is the ambulatory glucose profile? You know that there are so many glucose meters out there in the market. There are four different types of CGMs in the market and three insulin pump that integrates with the CGMs. And each one of these used to provide the data differently on their proprietary software or downloading platform. So the physicians and the patients have really hard time in understanding the glucose data through the different CGMs, through different pumps and glucose meter. And so to make it a standardized way to look at the glucose data, to have a standardized interpretation, the international consensus and the expert came up with is called as ambulatory glucose profile, AGP. And you can see here on the screen, it's a three different AGP screenshots taken from three different CGM system. On the top left upper panel, it's the Libre view from a freestyle Abbott Libre. On the right side is the Dexcom Clarity from the Dexcom G6. And at the bottom is the Eversense DMS taken from the Eversense Sensionic CGM. So nowadays, all these glucose meters and the CGMs have a very standardized way of reporting glucose data through the AGP. The best way to find or identify the common glucose or CGM pattern is to review the ambulatory glucose profile. And here is my easy way of interpreting the ambulatory glucose profile in less than 1 minute for you. So the first thing you're going to look into the AGP is that whether the patient is using CGM for at least the 70% of the time in last 2 weeks. If they don't use that CGM for long enough, then the data may not be interpretable. Then review the glucose statistics, which is on the left upper panel of the AGP report, like for example, the mean glucose, the GMI, that's a glucose management indicator, and the time in various target range, like a time in range and time above range and time below range, which is shown in the right side, the upper panel of the AGP. Then look at the glucose pattern in the middle part of the AGP. It's just the best way to visualize the glucose data 24/7 and try to identify the issues with this glucose data. For example, in this patient is having a high before going to bed, coming down too much by morning time and having an highs after meals. And then discuss with the patient why he or she is having those issues. And the patient will tell you the story. And then you can identify a problem causing that pattern and an action to resolve that. Each patient with diabetes is very different, and so it's really hard or difficult to come up with the common glucose patterns. However, in my opinion, these are the most four common glucose patterns that you will be seeing in your clinical practice. And they are: number one, not enough data. Number two, persistent hyperglycemia. Number three, high glycemic variability, like a yo-yo glucose pattern. And the fourth one is the large drop in a glucose from an overnight period. Let's take a deep dive into each of these four most commonly seen glucose patterns. And number one is not enough data. Here, you can see a screenshot of a patient using a freestyle Libre system and not scanning frequently. When you see this kind of data, you wanna talk to the patient and think about why, or discuss about why the patient is not using CGM appropriately or why it's not scanning more often. There may be multiple reasons, right? Number one is that the patient doesn't like CGM. Patient doesn't like alerts and alarms, size and shape of the CGM, doesn't like something attached to the body, or forgets to scan that often. And so based on the discussion with the patient, you can come up with the approach to resolve this issue. The second most common glucose pattern you will be seeing in a clinical practice is the persistent hyperglycemia. Here you can see an AGP screenshot of a patient who is having a very high blood sugar throughout day and night, particularly at nighttime. If you see this kind of a pattern in your clinical practice, you may want to discuss with the patient why having in such a hyperglycemia, and there could be a couple of reasons. Number one, if it's a recently diagnosed type 1 diabetes, maybe a denial of disease. Patient doesn't want to take much insulin and having a hyperglycemia, or the patient have an hypoglycemia fear. In those patients, they are snacking at bedtime and having an hyperglycemia at nighttime because they don't want to have the blood sugar on the lower range during nighttime. In that case, you want to identify this pattern and try to make an appropriate action to resolve this problem. The third common glucose pattern you will be seeing in a clinical practice is the high glycemic variability, and I call it like a yo-yo glucose profile, where the patient would have hyperglycemia followed by a large drop in a glucose and again hyperglycemia. If you see this pattern, the most common reason for this is that the patient having a mismatch between the insulin, the timing of insulin with their food. And so in that case, you want to discuss with your patients about when they are taking their insulin, how long prior to their meals, what is the carb ratio, the correction factor, and also discuss with your patient about not over-treating the hypoglycemia, because the hyperglycemia followed by hypoglycemia is sometimes because of an over-treatment of hypoglycemia, and that can sometimes lead to this hypo kind of a patterns. The fourth most common glucose pattern you will be seeing is the large drop in a glucose level, particularly at the overnight time. This is a very common in patients with type 2 diabetes who are on a basal insulin only. When you see this kind of an glucose profile in patients with type 2 diabetes on a basal insulin, this means that the patient is on a very high basal insulin. There are studies that says that if the bedtime glucose minus the early morning, that's an AM glucose, this is called as beam factor, BEAM factor. So bedtime minus the AM, if it's a greater than 50 to 55 milligram per deciliter, that is considered as a large drop in a glucose overnight, and that indicates a very high basal insulin. In that case, you may want to consider the postprandial therapy or adding in postprandial insulin and reduce the basal insulin. For more information by the American Diabetes Association time in range, you can visit the website professional.diabetes.org/time-in-range.